Lord, lighten our hearts this morning as we come before God in prayer. And before we sing Psalm 973, I have many on our prayer list this morning that needs our prayers. The first one is Nelson Piercy from Hearts Content. He's diagnosed with cancer and he needs our prayers today and the following weeks that lie ahead. And I ask that you will keep him in your prayers. And also for Florrie Johnson and our daughter Eileen. And continue to remember Kenneth and Hilda at this time, and Mount for Holiday and Anne, also Anne of Wilson Dale, and the families who has been caused to mourn in recent weeks. And also our family focus for this week is Julie and Will John Dyle. So they have two grown children, Rodney and Noel, and also two grandchildren. And keep them in your prayers during this week. So we're going to pause and sing the Psalm 973. There is a place of quiet rest near to the heart of God, a place where sin cannot molest, near to the heart of God. O Jesus, blessed Redeemer, sent from the heart of God, hold us to wait before thee, near to the heart of God. Verses 1 and 2 together.
One of these days we're going to look upon your lovely face
and tell a story saved by grace. We praise you, Lord, because one of these days, Lord, you're going to come and receive us unto yourself. We thank you this morning, Lord, for all your love. We thank you, Lord, for health and strength and for food on our table, Lord, and everything for our heads. We thank you, Lord, for many blessings. Truly, Lord, we are a blessed people. We think of the things that are happening in our world today, Lord. When we look around and see, Lord, all those things that are happening, we know, dear Lord, that your coming is drawing near. You send your word when those things come to pass. We look up because our redemption is drawing nigh. We pray, dear God, for the peace of Israel. And we pray, dear Lord, that you will be with the leaders, Lord, that you will grant them wisdom, Lord, from day to day to do what is right and pleasing in your sight. We thank you, Lord, for this great country of ours, Canada, Lord. And we pray, oh God, that you will bless our leaders, our Prime Minister, Lord, and our premiers. We thank you, Lord, for them. And we pray, oh God, that you will grant them wisdom from on high. We pray for those today that are sick and laid aside our beds of pain. We ask, oh God, that you will visit them in a real way today, that they will feel your presence upon their soul and upon their body. We think of Nelson Piercy and his family at this time. We ask, oh God, that you will draw near to him, and that he will hold fast to your nails scarred hand. We pray, oh Lord, that you will give him faith to believe. And Lord, if he do not know you as his Savior, we pray that this will be the day that he will draw close to you and give his life to you. Heal his body in Jesus' name. We think of Flora Johnson and her daughter Eileen today. We pray, oh God, that you will be unto them all that they need. That you will grant them peace within their heart and in their soul and heal their bodies, Lord. We think of Ken and Hilda Silas at this time, and we ask, oh God, that you will be unto them all they need. And you know, dear God, they are faithful servants of yours. And we pray, dear Lord, that you will bless them and heal Ken's body. And think of Mumford Holiday and Anne at this time, Lord. And we ask, oh God, that you will draw close to them today and give them peace within their heart. And Wilson Dale, Lord, and Anne, we ask that you will bless them. Be drawn near to Wilson, Lord. We thank you that he's feeling much better. And we ask, oh God, that as he takes care of you, Lord, that he will get better and you will raise him up for your glory. We think of the families, Lord, that has been caused to mourn in recent weeks. And we ask, oh God, that you will draw near to them today and comfort their hearts. And we think of Judy and Will John at this time, Lord, and their family. We ask, oh God, that you will draw near to them. Be with Noel, Lord, and Rodney. And we ask, oh God, that you will bless them. We've missed Nano here in our midst, Lord. She wants to serve you, Lord, but we pray, oh God, that you will draw her back unto you and bless her, Lord. And you know, Lord, that your spirit's never left them. But we pray, oh God, that you will be around about all the young people, Lord, that's come through those doors. We ask, oh God, that you will be unto them all that they need, and they will think about you, Lord, and want to serve the God that they once served. We ask, oh Lord, that you will bless us each one today, that everything will be said and done here in this service this morning will be done for your honor and for your glory. We pray, dear Lord, you will bless your word as it goes forth. Bless your servant, Lord, as he or she breaks the bread. That may your Holy Spirit move in a mighty way in their life, that the words they say, Lord, will sink deep in the hearts of those who listen. And we ask, dear God, that some soul will find you before the door of mercy closes. And we will give you all the glory and the praise. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
That last verse says, there is a place of full release, near to the heart of God, a place where all is joy and peace, near